Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, August 11th, 2009. In the pre-market this morning, not a lot going on. We've got Fed meetings today and tomorrow and shouldn't see a lot of volatility in the market until after the Fed meetings are over. Let's start off this morning looking at the weekly charts. We need a weekly close below 920 before we'll get a new sell signal on the S&P 500. Now, we did get a sell signal a month ago and quickly reversed, and what we want to look at is watch the VIX for confirmation. I didn't get that confirmation last time, and so we didn't go aggressively short. Next time around, if we do get the VIX confirming down move in the market, then we'll be a lot more aggressive to the downside with our long-term investments. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we need a weekly close below 1475 to give us a new weekly sell signal. Looking at the SOX index, SOX looks like it's topping right now, and we've got a sell signal on the daily charts. We need a weekly close below 279 to give us a weekly sell signal for the SOX. For bank stocks, which have just shot up incredibly in the last week, we need a weekly close below 105 right now to give us a new weekly sell signal for bank stocks. For the XAU, looks like that's topped. We need a weekly close below 139 for gold stocks to give us a new weekly sell signal. I have had little interest in gold the past couple of months. I've been looking, comparing it to other opportunities in the market. I didn't think gold was the place to be. Still looking for a significant sell-off before we go into the fall and then look for a seasonal rally into Christmas. Looking at the VIX, we need a weekly close above 29 to give us a weekly buy signal in the VIX. And notice 5 weeks ago, the VIX did punch through the upper channel line, but certainly did not close there. In fact, it closed at the low of the week. So that certainly did not confirm an up move in the VIX and a down move in the stock market. Looking at the daily charts for Tuesday's trading activity, we need a daily close below 984 on the S&P 500 to give us a new daily sell signal on Tuesday. A daily close below 1595 for the NASDAQ 100. We're on a daily sell signal for the SOX index. We need to see a daily close above 305 to kick us out of any short positions in the SOX index. First target to the downside should be that open gap. Looking at financial stocks for Tuesday, we need a daily close below 116. Obviously, the channel line is continuing to move higher, and we'll get closer to where we're trading as the week progresses. Looking at the XAU, right on the cusp of a sell signal right now. Again, no interest in chasing any gold stocks at the present time. Looking at the VIX, daily close above 25.80 would give us a new daily buy signal and help confirm lower stock prices. Of course, if we continue to move lower on the VIX and start to close below the channel, that should be supportive for higher stock prices. Looking at the 30-year bond, we need a daily close above 128.50 on Tuesday to give us a new daily buy signal. For the U.S. dollar, it's on its second day, going into the third day of a buy signal. We need a daily close below 78.10 to kick us out of this position. Looking at crude oil, very stalled up there above 70. We're hoping to get to 75. That doesn't look like it's going to happen. A daily close below 68.75 on Tuesday would give us a new sell signal. Natural gas, hey, we're on a sell signal again. Again, I don't want to be in this market until we see some long-term changes. And last but not least this morning, gold, now on a daily sell signal. A daily close above 9.59 would kick us out of any short positions in gold on Tuesday. Looking at the 60-minute charts, we've been using the midterm instead of the right side, and that served us well over the past couple of weeks. An hourly close below 1,000 would give us a new intraday sell signal for the S&P 500 cash index. An hourly close above 1625 would give us an intraday buy signal for the NASDAQ 100. An hourly close above 302 on the SOX index would give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. For the XAU, for gold stocks, an hourly close above 149 would give us a new buy signal. And last but not least, if we saw the VIX start closing below 2440, that would be supportive to higher stock prices on Tuesday. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.